Okay, all right, guys. God bless you guys, and welcome to This Is It Before the Fire. I'm here with Corey again. Let's see how the audios are working.
Hey, church. Good to see you.
Yeah, there we go. So anyway, so I'm checking in. I kind of wanted a witness to what's going on here. So I'm just going to blurt it out, and then I'll let Corey talk. I'm going to hand Corey the mic and let him talk. So I have information and I have data that is world changing. It'll change the world forever. I know you guys are like, I know we've heard that, but here's what you haven't heard. I've been working so hard and so diligently to get this together for you guys. You want to comment on that?
On top of, we have this project. I know Jonathan has had to be pretty vague about it, but we have a huge project. We've been working every day, lots of sweat, exhaustion, lick at Johnny's hand. So that's over and above what the Lord has delivered to our brother Jonathan. And I'm talking, this has been going on for 2 weeks, but more so in the past week, where, and it's just, all I can say is it's total supernatural as a witness, and it's daily.
And it keeps rolling out.
And exactly. The thing of it is right when, and look, I've been working with Johnny every single day, side by side, and it's a burden, trust me. As a witness, it is a burden. So, yeah, he's a slacker. Just kidding. Just kidding. But it is a huge burden slacker on our brother to carry. This kind of knowledge is going to totally crush the enemy and totally crush the lie that we have all been birthed into. I'm talking, it's going to smash it. So, right when Johnny thinks that he's got it, then what does Dad do? There's more. He'll supernaturally tell Johnny there's more. And I'm buzzing right now.
He's buzzing and my body's convulsing.
Exactly. Yeah, yeah. So if this is an ongoing thing and Dad's rolling it out perfect according to his will.
Not mine.
Not Johnny's will. It's according to Dad. The Lord God. So it's a huge burden. And yesterday, Johnny was just all lit up. We thought we had it. He had it. He can cross-reference this all across everything. And then Dad says, wait, there's more. And so, but it's coming. It is coming quickly. I'm not going to speak for Johnny, but it's coming quickly. I can tell you he's got it. He owns it. He can cross-reference it on lots of different, all across the board. And we went out today, and we're just looking at each other, driving around, and we're just going, wow. Because it's everywhere. It's manifesting. He's even has a testimony today where he went into a Kinko's. He's got a whole testimony about that where it just manifests right there, right there. And then he walks out of Kinko's because I sat in the truck, and then he comes in into the, he comes out from Kinko's and back into the truck, and he's like, you're not going to believe what just happened. So it's crazy.
It's nonstop.
It's happening. So
here's the thing about it, so y'all understand. The burden that I carry, you can't even conceive it. You can't. It would be like trying to conceive, like the Lord told Noah to build an ark, and you know he's got to build an ark, and it's like, well, it's done. I think it's done. So anyway, so I've wanted to roll the data out in the past 3 days. Like, I wanted to do it yesterday. I wanted to do it the day before. And I even said, okay, that's it. I'm stopping. I'm not adding any more to it because I've got too much. When do you have too much information? And I just said, that's it. And I heard the Lord say very clearly, you got to wait. There's more. Was there more? And it's mind destroying. It's like, it is so over the top. It just tears down the veil. It's like, you know, the song King Floyd, The Wall. Just picture a guy walking up to the wall with a freaking bulldozer and just knocking the damn thing down because there's no more wall. The wall's gone now. And the guy talking to you, I'm the conduit. And he's a witness. There's lots of witnesses. I've had other people that, you know, like Kat and her husband getting supernaturally healed. The guy, Juan the plumber that was blind, and him getting, you know, healed his blind eye within 15 minutes. So the Lord's used me on these levels that I find hard to believe myself. I'll just be honest. I'll look at you. I find it hard to believe. I actually laugh. I'm like, what are you joking? I do. I laugh. I'm like, what are you kidding, Lord? What are you joking? I mean, I can't believe. Why are you allowing me to do and understand all this stuff? Because it's literally understanding the mystery of everything. I mean, everything. Our existence, the beginning of the earth, the beginning of the system, the host body system, how it started, you know, and I can cross-reference it right in front of you. Over and over and over and over and over again with disparate sources.
True or not true? All day.
Literally all day long. I could do it all day long now. So, and I want to package it and give it to you. And the Lord is using me to package it and give it to you. However, when I'm ready to go, okay, I think I got everything ready to go. I've got my scriptures to give them. I can cross-reference. I can show them these images. I'll lead them into this. I'll show them this. And then the Lord tells me, stop. Slow down. There's more. And I'm like, and I'm like, I don't want any more. It's enough. I'm good. But it's not about me. The Bible says in the end, everything secret will be made public. And so I'm trying to be the most obedient servant I know how to be, even though I'm going to say this in front of Corey very blatantly. I don't want to carry this burden anymore. I don't. I do not. I do not want to wake up in the morning knowing that I've got to deliver this and that, you know, the world, I mean, so this information will get out. It's already out in its own form. But I have to deliver it, and waking up in the morning knowing you have to deliver it, yeah, you can't even understand the burden. You can't even imagine it. You couldn't imagine it. It's like sky surfing. Either you've done it or you haven't. And I'm just trying to explain, it's experiential. And I have to receive this data on a daily basis. And it's in ways that are like, I can't even explain. They're miraculous over and over and over. It's miracle after miracle after miracle after miracle. And it overwhelms me.
I'll just say this. The hard work, the sweat, because it's hot. Last week was super hot, super humid. But I'll just say this. The hard work that the Lord has put upon Jonathan, our brother, to complete this task, it's a blessing because Jonathan will be so burdened that he'll literally go out at 11 o'clock at night and start digging holes
in the dirt,
just to deal with the burden. So, and I'm not the point man, I'm just witnessing it, and I have to go lay down. I've had to go lay down several times just to talk to Dad, talk to the Lord, pray about it, and just be like, wow, really? Exactly. So I'm grateful for the hard work just so I can get through the day, and I'm not even, I'm just here as a witness to see all this manifest. So thank you, Lord.
So that being said, so now, because I know y'all, look, let me look at you. I know y'all are like waiting with bated breath, like, hey, come give it to us, like, I can't. It's like you can't pull the souffle out of the oven until it's ready. But trust me when I tell you, the information's come in. And now I'm processing, I'm organizing, and let me show you something. Okay. I'm talking to you from one of my laptops. This is another laptop I have. I have two more laptops. Okay, on every one of these laptops, I've gone through the scriptures, and I've gone through Esword, and I've walked back these definitions led by the Lord. I have been taught the scriptures by the Lord God himself. And I've walked back these definitions and these words. That's how he let me prove out Genesis 1 was not the Lord God. It was Elohim said, let us create man in our image. The word, I own it. The word is Selem, vain show, representative figure, especially an idol, phantom image. That's not the Lord God. That's Elohim. Okay, so in order to receive this kind of data and this kind of information, this kind of truth, I have to be in contact with the creator of all things. And it's not describable. It's overload. It's overload. If it would overload you to a point there you can't even understand. So anyway, I'm doing my best. I'm receiving the data. I've got the data. I own the data. I own the understanding now. And so now I'm putting it together. And see this computer right here? This has eSword highlighted. The other two computers have eSword highlighted. This computer that I have that's working doesn't have all the eSword stuff highlighted. So I sat down today going like, oh my gosh, well, I can't just jump to this computer to do the video. Because this one's not working like this one's functioning. This is the one that's functioning properly that I can stretch the screen on and do all the stuff I need to do for y'all. But I know that the Lord God's in control of all of it also. And y'all have to realize that I'm not in control of when it comes out. Do you think Jesus was in control of the fact that it, you know, the Bible says there was darkness over all the land from the sixth hour to the ninth hour? Well, no, the Lord God was. And at the very moment he died, he was in control of all of it. Same as the information rolling out. I've got it, like I said, and I'm processing it. I wanted to give it to you yesterday, and I tried.
Did I try?
I tried. And the Lord said, no, there's more. So hang on one sec, guys. I got to grab something. Let me pause something. Sorry, some of the guys I wanted. So anyway, so I tried, and I tried to do it the day before. But then I'll hear the Lord say, just slow down. There's more. And thank God I didn't deliver it 2 days ago. Because now what I have is like... It's just, it'll make you like, I mean, the world that sees us, that if you're not converted and you see this, I don't know what it'll do to you. It might send you instantly to a therapist or in the corner sucking your thumb, or either that or a demonic force will make you, you know, run from it or hate me or whatever. But because the truth of what's coming out is beyond people's ability to receive it, mostly. So anyway, that being said, I'm not going to keep belaboring the point. I know people are like, oh, you've said that 1,000 times. Yeah, but you know what? Until you're me, until you understand what I'm talking about. Guys, you're talking to the guy that the Lord God showed, the Vatican. Vatican, divining serpent. He showed this guy that the building itself is a snake on the ground. He showed the same person, the mouth of the snake is a vagina. Just stop and think about just that. Now, I can honestly look at you and tell you, I've got hundreds upon hundreds upon hundreds of revelations like that. And it's overwhelming me. I mean, it is literally overwhelming me. But he'll get it out, and he'll be out hopefully in a day or two. What I'm going to do now is, I'm going to play some commercials, because during the presentation of this data, and I'm going to try and make it fun. I don't want it to be serious, although it is very serious. But I'm going to try and just make it, yeah, if you don't have a light heart about it, I don't think you'll be able
to. You won't be able to do it. You got to laugh.
Yeah. At least a little. Okay, yeah. So I've been sitting here and I'll be laughing. And then I'll be crying. Then I'll be laughing. And then I'll be crying. Because it's a double-edged sword. It's the greatest thing in the world. It's the worst thing in the world. It's the paradox of all paradoxes. And so, I'm just saying, it's coming. And that's what's coming for all y'all. And a lot of y'all will get it right off the bat. You'll throw your hands in the air. You'll start laughing your ass off. and then you'll be then you'll process it. You'll be like, oh God. And then I'll have you watch an Ace Ventura clip, and you'll realize the Ace Ventura clip that I just showed you is directly relatable to everything the Lord let me see. And you'll be like, how is that possible? And then you'll freak out, and I'll use the names of the people's names, the meanings of their names, just like the meaning of Alice in Chains. Alice means of nobility, exalted. What do you think some guy would name his band Alice in Chains? What, does he have a girlfriend? He's all like into, hey, baby, let me chain you up. Yeah, no, that's not why. Alice in Chains is a reference to God's angels that have been caught in host bodies. Alice, of nobility, exalted in chains. Ha ha, ha ha. So we're talking that kind of revelation on steroids, on human growth hormone to the 100th power, okay? Over and over and over and over and over again. And y'all are going to get it. And I'm going to dump it on you. So, it's coming. So, now, no more of that. No more telling you it's coming because everyone's like, give it to us. I can't sleep. I know. I'm having a hard time too. I'm doing a lot of crying and laughing. So, I'm going to let you guys watch some commercials. I want to test them. I want to test the commercials because during the presentation of the data in the supernatural revelation, I mean, think about this. Barack Obama's presidential portrait is a T-Rex. He's a T-Rex. What? Yeah, I drew in the whole damn thing. I drew in every leaf, every change of shadow, and the Lord God working through me revealed that it was a T-Rex. Why is Barack Obama a T-Rex? Why is Barack Obama the whole thing turned into a serpent and the fang of the serpent is a sperm? Because the serpent's bite was a sperm. That's why. And so all these kind of revelations, one upon another, that I've been holding on to and I've been accumulating over all these years, they fit together like a 100,000 piece puzzle, and the last puzzle piece has gone in, and it's like, oh my Lord. And there's another race of beings here, and they're going to take over the host body system. This is what's coming. This is what's happening right now. It is happening. I can show it to you live. I can show it to you live. I can go into anywhere and show it to you. They're taking over right now. The system is being taken over. The dragon is giving its power unto the beast, which is the host body system that was created, because the host body system is a beast. And they're getting ready to turn on all the host bodies that have sheep in them. And they're going to kill them all. Okay, I guarantee it. It's the end of the world. I'm the before the fire guy. And I'm trying to keep it lighthearted. And so now I'm going to show you guys some commercials that I'm going to add to, this presentation of data and this revelation. I'll give you the scriptures. And it's going to be 3 or 4 hours of just dump and just me sitting around. Hey, let's look at this one. Let's go to this one. Let's cross-reference this one. Let's go to the Bible. And that's what we're going to do for 3-4 hours. It's probably going to be at least 3 or 4 hours. I'll have to take several breaks just to get it out. So I'm going to be putting these commercials in during that time. And I'm going to play these for you. I want you to watch them all in a row. You tell me if any one of these commercials is actually selling a product. Any one of them. And there's going to be extras, but I want to check these out. Okay, now, I've been yakking for 19 minutes. And I'm going to stop because I got more work to do. I mean, guys, literally on a daily basis, 4 shirts soaking wet is normal. That's how hard I've been going at it. And so, yeah, y'all pray for me, man, that I can just bear up under this kind of a load. It's intense. And then I want to take a moment to say thank you. Thank you for your encouragement, your cards, your support. The financial support has made it so much easier for me not to freak out, because I'm like, how do I do all this? It's like Grand Junction on steroids times 1,000. And I'm going to get it done. The Lord will make sure I get it done. But y'all's help has just level the playing field for me, because my enemy does not want me to get any of this done. So, all right. So here the commercials come. You have my word that I will stay with what I'm doing to the very best of my ability and to diligently put myself out there for the well-being of all of y'all, over myself, over my own well-being. I will put your spiritual well-being and your being able to receive this over my well-being, health-wise or anything else. I don't care. This is more important than me. It's bigger than me. It's bigger than my life. It's bigger than all of that. So I'm willing to lay it down for all y'all to have it. I don't care. I don't care at all. So anyway, I will do my very best, and I hope in the next couple days I'm able to say, okay. You want to say anything before we go?
Yeah. I love all you guys. Praise El.
El, the Almighty God. That's why Jesus is Emmanuel. Isn't that cool that he let me understand his name and that I could share the actual name of the Lord God with you? You know, all this Elohim nonsense and, you know, and people like to get in these weird little discussions. Well, Elohim means God. Sure it does. It's a generic name for God as well. But he's taught me over and above anyone I've ever seen. This is just weird. It's hard to talk about to the general public sometimes, because it's like, guys, I'm sorry, but I've never seen anyone on this thing you call the earth that has the knowledge that the Lord God's given me. No one. And it's not because I'm smart. It's just because that's what he destined me for. So, anyway. All right, let's do the commercials, and I'll shut up. And I love you guys. Thank you. And I am diligently working to get it out. But there was more. There's more. Okay, here we go. Let's do the commercials. All right. There you go. Watch these and tell me what they're actually selling. Just for a second, do you see where she punched him? Go look at Alice in Chains' Greatest Hits. It's the same thing. It's a guy knocking someone out, just like she knocked him out, and he was stuck in the vesica piscis, the intersection of the two sets, the tree of the knowledge of good and evil. And we are that tree. Let's keep watching.
Alright, he's alone. I'll send her in.
Hey.
Hello.
How are you?
I'm very well. How are you?
I'm Kelly.
Ian.
Ian?
Ian. Pleasure to meet you.
If I give this to you, are you up for whatever happens next?
3 seconds ago, we gave Ian Rappaport a Bud Light and a choice. Ian is not an actor. He has no idea what's going to happen next.
I think I could do that.
All right, he's in the limo, Reggie. That's you.
How are you?
What's your name?
Ian Rappaport.
Ian Rappaport.
Ian. Oh.
I hope I don't mess it up.
Hey.
Hi.
Ian. Very nice to
Minka,
meet you.
Nice
Minka,
to meet you.
Definitely know who you are.
We need a coat for
okay.
Ian.
It's pretty awesome being styled by Minka Kelly tonight.
I wish I could come with you.
I know. I wish you can too.
Bye, guys.
Minka, that was awesome.
Joe.
Good evening.
Hello, Lily.
Hey!
There. Come on, Lily. Lily.
Hey, Don. How are you?
Hey, how's it going?
Nice to see you.
Are we wearing the same coat?
Yeah, nice dress.
Stand by. Hey,
Cap. Open the door.
Door, 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 door.
Twins?
Yes.
This is a bizarre night.
Take care, Ian.
Everyone here is a twin?
My mind is blown.
They're on their way down.
They appear to be crushed in tiny tennis.
Okay, let's see the arms. You all look all pumped up. Very good. Just give me 5 push-ups.
1, 2.
I knew it! Ring it up. They're beautiful girls, huh? Don't be shy when it comes to counting for me. You can do better than that. Come on. Ready, my little man here. It's not a bad shot for my little princess.
If he gets one more coin, he wins.
The perfect beer for when you somehow find yourself in a limo with Reggie Watts and some bachelorettes, then get styled by Minka Kelly before Don Cheadle, a llama named Lily, and the identical twin of the girl you just met take you to a party where you defeat Arnold Schwarzenegger in a sudden death ping pong match that puts you on stage with One Republic. Bud Light, the perfect beer for whatever happens.
I'm going to pause that for a second. I just want you to think about this. That the Lord would show me exactly what that all means biblically. I mean, that's a biblical commercial, the whole darn thing. The whole thing. I can break it down for you like that now. Stuff I didn't even see in 2014 when I did it. Now I know. Now I own it. I own that. I know exactly what that is. So who could even tell you what that really is? Does anybody have any clue? No. So anyway, these are the kind of things I'm talking about, but this is over and above anything like that you've seen so far. It's so far beyond the human mind what's coming. The revelation, it's the end of the world. And this won't change your status, what I'm going to reveal to you. It's not going to change your status with Christ. It's just like turning on the light in the treasure room. It's like getting to see all the treasure. It's just like, yeah. And, you know, like I said, it's going to challenge you. It's going to challenge you. Let's watch another commercial. The best night of my life. Yeah. Okay.
The world is full of giants. They have always been here. Lumbering in the schoolyards, limping through the alleys. We had to learn how to deal with them, how to overcome them. We were small, but fast. Remember? We were like a wind appearing out of nowhere. We knew that being clever was more important than being the biggest kid in the neighborhood. As long as we keep our heads down, as long as we work hard, trust what we feel in our guts, our hearts, then we're ready. We wait until they get sleepy. Wait until they get so big they can barely move. Then we walk out of the shadows. Quietly walk out of the dark. And strike.
So, let me just stop that one. So, you know, we kept our head down. We knew that being clever was more important than being the biggest kid on the block. It's a reference to the Giants in Genesis. Who is we? Who is we? Who's she talking about? Who's we? You think it's Maserati? No. We is even in Scooby-Doo. Yeah, you guys are going to go over the top. So, yeah, all these commercials, who's we? Who's she talking about? Who's Lady Gaga talking about when she says, my performance at the Grammys Awards is about a new race of beings being birthed within the human race? What race of beings is that? What is Whoopi Goldberg talking about when she's talking to Barack Obama? I want you to listen to this question Whoopi Goldberg asked Barack Obama. And you're going to be seeing this in the upcoming presentation. She looks at Barack and she goes, I ask you now, who are we? What are we? What? What? Did you just say, I ask you now, who are we? What are we? Well, if you're a race of beings that had taken over, that had started a planet, we'll just call it Earth, that had started this dimension, and you sucked in a bunch of angels as bait that got led astray into the system, and you were devouring them, and you were wondering where all society was going as you were watching y'all's race just taking over, that would be a pretty good question. Well, we're like, who are we? What are we? Where's all this going? And then your fearless leader, Barack Obama, who, by the way, his presidential portrait's a damn reptile, says, well, you know, we're all tied together, and our futures are all tied together, because they are, because DNA tied them all together. And we all have common hopes and aspirations, because if you're all caught in the same host body, that's true too. And he says, and you know, but one part that's still true today is we all have a reptilian part of our brain. What? Well, that's so Whoopi Goldberg's question is a very good question if she's a reptilian, as she's a reptile race, and they know it. Why do you think Oprah's production company is Harpo, which is Oprah backwards? Why would you make your production company your name backwards? How about Isaiah 29? Woe unto them who go to great depths to hide their plans from the Lord, and their works are in the darkness. And they say, who seeth us? Who knoweth us? Surely your turning of things upside down shall be esteemed as the potter's clay. And I showed you that in Genesis 2, when the Lord God, which is Jesus, because I showed you Jesus is the Lord God from 1 Corinthians 15:45. The Lord, let me cross-reference that. The Lord God formed Adam, formed as a potter from the dust, from the clay. So the Lord God formed his creation of man, Adam. He named him Adam. Genesis 1 was a serpent race. The original, like Adidas original, you know? You know, the Adidas original commercial, you know? We did it our way. Remember they sang, I did it my way? Yeah. So I can go on. And on.
And on.
And on. Because I can cross-reference so much stuff now that your head will spin off your body, because I own it now. The Lord put a lot into me to get this out. It'll be out in the next couple of days. Anyway, and I also have a failsafe on the data. If anything were to ever happen to me, the data would go out anyway. And the Lord would raise up whoever he needed to. So it doesn't matter. I mean, the reception of the knowledge and the data is already done. It's already done. So it's a done deal. But the video that I'm going to do for you, I don't want to be in a hurry. I don't want to, I'm under some I'm already under so much pressure. I just, you know what? I'm just going to give it to you, and I'm just going to give it to you nice, smooth, steady. I don't care if it's 4 to 6 hours. I'll do it. You think little girls drive Maseratis? Who's we? We keep our head down. We keep working. Then we slowly walk out of the darkness, slowly walk out of the shadows, slowly come out of the darkness. And strike. Strike what? Strike a match? Strike what? And they're, you watching what's going on in society right now? That was a great commercial. That was about 11-year-old girl, I guess, selling you a Maserati. That's normal, right? Of course. Let's watch another commercial.
In a world that is bland, colorless, and cold, where banality grows like a fungus or a mold, there live the boring sheeple who look just like each other. A darker force rides into town, unleashing demon brothers. Here come the little deviants. They come from underground. They're rising from the depths to take those sheeple down. The sheeple are compliant and make for fine ingredients. For customizing anything, here come the little deviants.
Okay, so, you know, let's just be honest. Everybody goes to buy cars where sheep get their heads cut off. It's a no-brainer, duh. Of course there's little deviants that come from underground unleashing demon brothers to sell cars. That's a no-brainer. Every car is sold by unleashing demon brothers to kill sheeple. It's nothing here. We prepared, now we strike, no big deal. You know, my performance at the Grammy Awards is about a new race of beings being birthed within the human race, and so, it's everything. And when it's everything, it becomes nothing. And everybody that's asleep is going to wake up in a horror movie, because the horror movie is getting started right now. I got to experience it the night I got saved. The night I got saved, after I prayed and I received the Holy Spirit, and after I was just glowing, I was given my marching orders by Michael. By the way, he is God's militant angel. I don't care if you believe I met him or not. The record will speak for itself now. All you got to do is look at what the Lord's let me show the world. And if you don't believe I met him, you're delusional. So anyway, I don't really care. The record will speak for itself. So, I mean, 12-year-old girl selling Maseratis. We come out of the darkness and we strike. Little deviants coming from underground, unleashing demon brothers. And the people are compliant. They make for fine ingredients. I mean, duh. For customizing anything. Even your Scion. Here come the little deviants. I mean, it's just a car commercial. Lady Gaga's little dance at the, at the MTV Music Awards with her mask on. The whole mask thing isn't some giant earth occult ritual. No, listen, there's really a serious disease called COVID-19. By the way, see Abaddon. C is number 3, which is in the Bible. That's Abaddon, angel of the bottomless pit. The word Ovid is Latin for sheep, and 19 just happens to be the number in the Bible for slaughter. So, see Abaddon, Ovid, sheep, 19 slaughter, Abaddon, sheep, slaughter. Nothing to worry about. Did that sign commercial have sheep getting slaughtered in it? Oh, it did, didn't it? That's weird. It's coincidental. I've seen a lot of coincidences lately. I see them every day. They're everywhere, as a matter of fact. As a matter of fact, I can make videos all day long now. So, y'all starting to notice a pattern here, right? By the time I'm done with the next video, the pattern will be complete. So, go buy a Scion or a Maserati when you're done with this video.
These are the little deviants.
That's wonderful. Pause out right now. Of course you go to the desert and glass wieners come out of the ground. It's like a no-brainer, duh. Don't y'all go to the desert and see glass wieners? Whatever. Anyway, let's just check this out, because if y'all don't, y'all must be weird. I think this would be a good time for a ooh. Ooh. What's going on here? That is one hell of a perfume, eh? Huh? Yeah? Did you catch all that? I mean, it's normal, right?
Good afternoon and welcome.
Hello?
I guess I said good afternoon and welcome. Can we lose the masks? Just take them off.
I'm just going to interrupt for a sec. Don't you think it's kind of funny? By the way, I'll show you. I'll weave it into the delivery of the information that's coming. The Joker movie, the new Joker with Joaquin Phoenix, they totally told you what was coming. COVID and against police. You know, this whole a cop against the police. It was all right there in Joker. I can show it to you. I can show it to you in a way that's so supernatural, you'll go, oh. Yeah. Yeah. See, when it's everything, it becomes nothing. You have to be set apart to see it all. And y'all are going to get to see it from a whole new vantage point. Now, back to this. By the way, I want to tell you, most CDs with music on them, they have at least 23 tracks, okay? I don't know if you've ever had a CD that has 23 tracks, but I haven't. But I know there's 23 chromosomes in each parent's DNA that's donated during sexual intercourse. Have y'all ever looked up the meaning of the word intercourse? We'll do it in the next video. That's good.
How can we be a secret?
Wow, look at that. It's track 23. And then a pause button sure looks like the Twin Towers.
How can we be a secret society if we can't keep all of our secrets?
Do they know we faked the moon landing?
No, not yet.
Or that there are only 49 shades of gray?
They're suspicious, but that's not what I'm talking about.
What about Bigfoot?
Bigfoot's not real and everyone knows that.
Did they figure out we deflated the footballs?
No, we found a fall guy for that one.
Bigfoot's definitely real.
Nope.
Okay. We'll just have to agree to disagree.
What about Area 51? Do they know about that?
No.
How about Area 52 to 54?
Oh, stop saying areas. No areas plus a number.
Literally hundreds of photos of Bigfoot.
Okay.
Yeah, I saw him once. Wait, Bigfoot? I'm getting it wrong. Paul Bunyan?
Point is, someone is leaking this stuff.
Why are you looking at me?
I'm not looking at you, Anne.
I've seen his footprint when I was
Scott! What they do know is that avocados from Mexico have good fats.
So they know they're healthy.
They know everything. Kyle, are you streaming this?
Is that not cool?
No, it's not cool. That's what secret means. It's a secret society.
Oh, wow. Secret, yep. Hey, I got a like.
You got a like?
That was me.
I like you too.
At least they don't know about subliminal advertising.
That's not even a thing, right?
Eat them!
So, that's not a commercial about self-cannibalization. Nah. Yeah, those are all normal commercials. I can show you hundreds of these. None of them are normal. But when you're in it, you're in it. So anyway, I wanted to run those tonight. So I'll see if there's any copyright issues, if y'all have any issues. And now I won't belabor the point. I'm just being very, very, because those commercials are meant for one thing and one thing only. For that other race of beings that Lady Gaga was talking about, you know, the new race of beings that's being birthed within the human race, which is what Lady Gaga is, what this commercial was, what the Little Deviants was, what the Maserati commercial was, what the Ian Bud Light commercial was. That's what they all were. They were all shooting the bird at you, making fun of you while they're slaughtering you. And then I'm going to take this back and I'm going to show you the origins of these guys. You know, we come out of the darkness and we strike those guys. I'm going to show you the darkness they're going to come out of. I'm going to show you where they came from. I'm going to show you who they were and who they are now and what they're going to be. So I'm going to show you all those things. And then I'm going to breathe a huge sigh of relief knowing that I was just able to elucidate to you what's been shown to me in a very mind-bending supernatural revelation. This is a revelation of the end of the world. I have a revelation gift. It is straight from the King himself. And you know what? I know I'm kind of crusty, but y'all, you have to be. You couldn't do this without a personality a little bit like mine. You'd have to be able to do it. So anyway, so I love you guys in Christ, and I love y'all all, and I appreciate everything that y'all have done to help support me to get me to this point so I didn't go off the deep end, because yeah, it's tough, and I will tell you, y'all have no idea of the load I'm carrying. You can't even imagine it, emotionally, mentally, physically. The physical load is brutal. I mean, brutal, but thank God for it, because if I didn't have it, the mental load would be too much. I couldn't handle it. I think that, I bet Noah was going, like, you give me another big board now, right now. I'm freaking out. So anyway, all right, guys, we love you. Corey, you want to say bye to everybody?
Yeah, I love you guys. Praise El, and it's coming soon, so be ready. Be ready.
Yeah, and the end is coming really soon. So anyway, y'all just stay the course. Get up and pray. Pray during the day. Talk to the Lord all day long. Just, he's coming. He's coming to grab his people. And these hosts, these shells that we're in, these are shells. You're in a shell. You're literally a ghost in a shell. You're who you are, your essence, and what in who you really are, you have no idea. Your body is not who you are. Not at all. I'll prove it. All right, guys. I love you in Christ. And I hope you bear with me. Sorry, I may be, you know, be a little redundant. It's one of my best qualities. Okay, I love you guys. Bye.